Hi everyone, and welcome to my channel. In this video, I'm going to show you how I make my DIY in-ear monitors with one dynamic driver and one balanced armature driver. This project is beginner friendly and budget friendly, and very easy to make. I use a Sonion 2354 balanced armature driver as the main driver, and a 10mm dynamic driver as a bass extension, making the IEM sound BA-like with excellent detail, clean and good bass and sub-bass. If you're interested in learning how to build your own in-ear monitors, or if you're just curious to see how it's done, I hope this video helps and entertains you. I also provide the shell 3D asset in the video description. I'm modeling the shell with Fusion 360. I won't go into detail in this process, but if you're curious how it's done, check out my video on how to make the best fit in IEM shell. The shell consists of a top and bottom part. I export them separately as STL files. Then, I import them into 3D printer slicer software for 3D printing. After finishing printing, I cut and remove the printing supports and polish the shells. After cleaning the shell, I install a 0.3 by 0.6mm diameter air vent tube for releasing air pressure in the ear canal. Then I carefully install the drivers and glue them to the shell using UV glue. The type of glue I use is not strong, so in case something goes wrong, I can retrieve the drivers without damaging them. I install a 330 ohm Knowles damper for each nozzle before the tuning process. I won't show the tuning process here because it's quite boring. This is after the crossover tuning circuit is decided. After that, I use SMD capacitors and resistors to make the final crossover circuit. The crossover schematic and frequency response of the IEM. I glue the capacitors and resistors to the shell, manage the wires, and solder the 0.78mm 2-pin connector. I drill a small hole in the side of the shell to make an air vent for the IEM. I glue the 0.78mm connector to the top part of the shell, and then I glue the top and bottom parts together. Finally, I apply lacquer to the shell. This is when the magic happens, the shell suddenly becomes clear, shiny, and beautiful. If you enjoyed this video, please give it a thumbs up and subscribe to my channel for more. Thank you for watching.